from finding your way around the sound browser to using touch instruments and recording audio. In this video, I'm sharing 5 tips to help you get started with GarageBand on iPad and iPhone. The first time you open GarageBand for iOS or start a new project, you'll be taken to the sound browser. This is where you can choose a touch instrument to play, add more sounds, or record an external instrument through your iDevice's built-in microphone or via an audio interface. You can also switch between the tracks and live loops view here. I'm going to focus on the track side of things in this video, but I'll cover live loops in depth in an upcoming video. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that. Swipe left or right to view the different instruments available, then tap on the one you want to play. The options in the lower parts of these cards take you directly to chord strips, notes view or scales on touch instruments, gives you different rhythm input options on drum and drummer cards, allows you to jump straight into certain presets on amp and audio recorder cards, and allows you to select from different third-party instrument options on the external card. It's worth noting that you can't access the tracks view at all until you've added at least one track. Each touch instrument has a play area and a controls area. The play area is where you can play melodies, chords, and sounds by touching the touch instrument's keys, strings, or other playable elements. You can change the sound of the instrument by using the knobs, buttons, and other controls in the controls area. Here's a closer look at GarageBand's guitar touch instrument. Using the touch guitar, you can play notes, chords, and strumming patterns. You can choose from acoustic or electric guitar sounds and add stomp box effects to customize its sounds further. Tap the guitar icon and select the sound that you want to play. Tap the chord slash note switch to change to the chords view. You can strum a chord by swiping across the strings in one of the strips. You can tap on the top of the chord strip to play a full chord, and you can mute the strings by touching and holding the fretboard to the left or right of the chord strips as you play. There's also an autoplay function. You use this by turning the autoplay knob to one of 4 positions and then tapping a chord strip. This will play a pattern with the notes of that chord. The autoplay pattern will change slightly depending on whether you tap with 1, 2, or 3 fingers, meaning there are up to 12 different autoplay variations for each touch instrument. Before we go any further, if you're finding this video helpful, then please give that like button a wee love tap. I really appreciate it. When you record a touch instrument, it appears as a region in the instrument's track in the tracks view. When you're ready, tap record in the control bar. Recording will start at the current position of the playhead. Now you can tap anywhere along the ruler at the top there to reposition the playhead, or hit this button to send the playhead back to the start of the section. The ruler shows the area being recorded in red. Any notes you play, as well as any changes to sliders, knobs, or other controls, are recorded as well. When you're done recording, tap the track button in the control bar. Your recording will then appear in the tracks view as a region. Current iPad and iPhone models have excellent built-in microphones, meaning you can get a great quality recording without any extra gear. From the sound browser, you can get back to this anytime by tapping this icon, swipe to and tap on audio recorder. As the on-screen prompt says, capturing your recording is as easy as pointing your iPad towards the sound you want to capture and hitting record. Obviously, knowing where the built-in microphone is on your iPad or iPhone will be helpful. To find where the mic is located on your model, just go to apple.com, look up your iPad model, and select Tech Specs at the top. Then just scroll down till you find the Buttons and Connectors section. The input meter on the right of the screen will tell you if you're too quiet or too loud. You're aiming for maybe just over halfway for an optimum recording level. And when you're ready to go, just hit record. Once you're finished recording, you can add some of these fun effects in the Fun tab, or you can tap on Studio, then the menu in the middle, and then Vocals for some more sensible and more usable presets. GarageBand includes a massive selection of Apple Loops, which are pre-recorded audio files that you can use to easily add drum beats, bass lines, rhythm parts, and other sounds to your project. You can quickly find loops in the loop browser and preview them to find the ones that you want to use in your song. All of the loops that you'll find in GarageBand are available on a royalty-free basis, so you can use them in any of your projects, commercial or otherwise, without having to worry about any copyright issues. Kind of. There's a whole big controversy at the minute about people using Apple Loops in their commercial releases. Check the linky in the dinky for more info on that. To access Loops, tap the Loop Browser button in the control bar. Bear in mind though that the Loop Browser button is only available in Tracks view. Here you can search by instrument, genre, or description, and the results list shows loops that match your search criteria. Drag a loop from the results list to an empty part of the Tracks view screen, and then align the left edge of the loop with the bar or part where you want it to start playing. Alright, I've put this playlist together especially for GarageBand beginners, so if you want to learn more, click here to learn more.